Hola, hola, ¿qué tal? In this lesson, you will learn how to ask people where they are from, and you'll learn why Spanish speakers who want to say you use either the pronoun tú or usted.
Spanish Awakenings, a free Spanish course for beginners by Web Spanish.
Welcome to Lesson 6. Bienvenido a la Lección 6. Now, in our story, Milagros is attending a photography exhibit where she bumps into a young man who's eager to know a little bit more about her. Now, see if you can catch where they say they're from and listen to how they address each other.
¿Usted no es de acá, verdad?
No, no soy de acá.
Disculpe. ¿De dónde es usted?
Yo soy...
¿Trujillo?
No, no soy de Trujillo.
Bueno, ¿de dónde es usted?
Yo soy de Ica.
De Ica. Interesante.
Sí. ¿Y usted es de acá?
No, soy de Cusco.
Cusco, bonito lugar.
Sí, sí.
Muy bonito.
Mire, ahí hay otros cuadros. ¿Vamos?
Sí, claro, vamos.
Now, listen again.
Usted no es de acá, ¿verdad?
No, no soy de acá.
Disculpe, ¿de dónde es usted?
Yo soy...
¿Trujillo?
No. No soy de Trujillo.
Bueno, ¿de dónde es usted?
Yo soy de Ica.
¿De Ica? Interesante.
Sí. ¿Y usted es de acá?
No, soy de Cusco.
Cusco, bonito lugar.
Sí, sí.
Muy bonito.
Mire, allí hay otros cuadros. ¿Vamos?
Sí, claro. Vamos.
Okay, Renzo is from Cusco and Milagros is from Ica, two cities in Peru. But they both wind up in the nation's capital, Lima. That's a fact of life here in Peru. People, particularly young people, gravitate towards the capital city because, you know, that's where the action is, that's where the work opportunities are. Did you know that Lima is now home to one-third of Peru's population? It's the headquarters for almost all of the large businesses, most of the important universities, the largest hospitals, the news outlets, the TV stations, and logically, it's the transportation hub for the nation too. Now, because Lima has become home to so many migrants from other regions, you'll often hear the expression, Lima is Peru. Lima es Peru. Hey, there's the verb ser again, es. Lima es Peru. Like we saw in earlier lessons, I use the verb ser to express to be because in my mind, Lima equals Peru. Lima es Peru. And when you think in terms of equals, you're describing the nature of something, right? You use ser, not estar. Lima es Peru. Now after Lima, Cusco, where Renzo is from, is probably the second most famous city in Peru because it used to be the capital of the Incan Empire. And Cusco is only a half-day train ride to Machu Picchu, the famed Incan hideaway, which is nestled in the folds of the Andes Mountains. Hey, by the way, you'll also see Cusco spelled Cusco with an S. Both spellings are acceptable. Anyway, both Lima and Cusco are attractive tourist destinations. But what about the city of Ica where Milagros is from? Well, Ica is a half day's drive south of Lima. The region is an agricultural powerhouse, and you know what? It's only a few hours away from the mysterious Nazca Lines. You've seen the pictures, the huge patterns carved into the arid grounds of the deserts. Archaeologists speculate, but you know, they still don't understand why the lines were made in the first place. Theories range from communication with extraterrestrials to being designs for elaborate dances danced on the desert floor. You know, nobody really knows. Okay, I know that you paid close attention to the dialogue, and I know that you noticed that Renzo and Milagros addressed each other with usted, which means you. But there are two different ways to say you in Spanish. You can say either usted, which comes with a sense of formality and maybe hierarchy, or you can use tú, which is much less formal. I repeat, in Spanish there are two ways to say you. You can say usted if you're being formal, respectful, hierarchical, or tú if you're on a more familiar eye-to-eye equal basis. It's a distinction that we've lost in English over the centuries, and since we don't really have an equivalent anymore, these two different levels of address can sometimes be tricky for first-timers. So, let me help you out with a few more examples. Say the person you want to address is 20 or 30 years older than you, or maybe they're your professor or some other authority figure, maybe a judge, or maybe a religious leader, maybe your doctor or your dentist. In many of these cases, you'll probably want to use usted. You might even want to use usted when addressing a stranger who's your own age, in the case that you want to maintain a polite distance. But on the other hand, tú is used when you feel comfortable enough to address others on a peer-to-peer basis. For example, with family, friends, colleagues, classmates, you can comfortably use tú. Now I want you to be forewarned that how people apply either tú or usted can vary depending on the country, the formality of the circumstance, the age of the people, or social status. For example, in Colombia, which is right next door to Peru, they use usted much more than we do here. Same goes for parts of Bolivia. You know, I have a couple of friends. They're a married couple, and they come from a city called Santa Cruz in Bolivia. And you know, they address each other as usted. It's not right or wrong, it's just different. So watch for clues. Well, no matter where you are though, some folks might find it offensive to be addressed informally in some situations. So when in doubt, it's your safest bet to use usted. If that person would rather be addressed informally, they'll politely correct you by saying, puedes tutearme, which means you may address me as tú. Puedes tutearme. Now the other important thing that you need to know is that depending on whether you use tú or usted for you, your verb ending will change. Why? Well, because usted is conjugated as if it were the third person. In other words, a he or a she. And that kind of makes sense when you think about it. I mean, when you use usted, you're putting a certain distance between yourself and the person that you're addressing. In much the same way that a third person, a he or a she, is also somewhat distant. Okay? You can check the verbs that we've included in the study guide and in the audios to see and hear how usted is conjugated. So do some review and you'll get it. All right, let's move on to something else. In the dialogue, we heard Milagros say, no soy de acá, which means I'm not from here. Acá, here. Now that's a useful little word, isn't it? By the way, there's a synonym for acá, which is aquí. You know, for all intents and purposes, these two words are interchangeable, but depending on the country, you might use one more than the other. Aquí, acá, whatever. Basically the same meaning. And how about the word for there, you might ask? Again, there's two options. You can say either allí or allá. All right, let's switch gears and let's talk about nationalities for a minute. In the first place, I want to say you can check the study guide of this lesson and find a list of words to describe your nationality. For example, say you're from Korea, you will see that you are coreano, or if you're a female, coreana. But a word of caution, if you're from the United States, don't make the mistake of saying that you are americano, or as a female, americana. The worldview in Latin America is that an americano or americana is simply someone from the American continent. So if you're from the US, it's much better to say that you are estadounidense, which, if you were to force the translation into English, would be something like a United States-er, estadounidense. The word's a little harder to pronounce than americano, but it's a better choice. And by the way, in this case, the word ending stays the same whether you're a man or a woman, estadounidense. Finally, one last thing. The study guide also contains the conjugation of the verb to go, ir. Ir is an irregular verb, so watch out for the spelling, but do take the time to learn it because ir, to go, is such a useful verb for beginners. By the way, when you listen to the audio and you review how ir is pronounced when it's conjugated, you'll see how the letter V in Spanish sounds a lot like a B. So heads up, in Spanish, there's almost no difference at all in how the V and the B are sounded. Okay, well, you've covered a lot of ground in this lesson. Good work. Now please take the time to review the dialogue until you really understand what the actors are saying, and put in the review time with the study guide so you can begin to make all of this new vocabulary your own. That's how this program works. You see and hear words and phrases in the context of a story, and then you put in the time to memorize them. Okay, time to wrap up. If you thought this lesson was useful, hey, share it with someone that you're rooting for. Maybe a friend who's also trying to learn Spanish. It'd be great if you can help us spread the word about the Spanish Awakening series. If you thought that you learned something in this lesson, give us a thumbs up. We'd like that too. Okay, until next time, hasta luego. Ciao.